All right, we never go into the charts looking for a trade. We go looking for a market structure and the wide open space. So there are three questions we must ask every single day. The first one has to do with structure. What are the big boys doing today and why? All right, once we got that figured out, the next one is probability. What is the next probable move of the big boys? And finally, risk. How much am I willing to risk to see if I am right? So we are focused on finding and understanding the market structure of the currency pair today in this room. So we are looking at market structure and looking for a wide open space with 55 pips or more. Or we might be looking for two smaller wide open spaces stacked on top of each other. This way we can press our winner without exception. Our trade, if we find one, will be filtered by the available ATR or average true range of the pair. So a fundy is a fundamental announcement, and so you must always be flat before a fundy on any currency that will be affected or potentially affected by this announcement, all right? So we will trade these on a 1 minute chart. The first thing we do is go down to a 1 minute chart and we ascertain the targets, all right? Then we will get a reaction to the news, all right? And that reaction, up or down, whichever way, we're showing it up one here, we'll go up. What do we need? Well, we need it to go sideways for 3 to 5 candles. If it goes sideways for 3 to 5 candles, we now have a piece of information. First of all, we won't get caught in a whipsaw as the big boys take out the straddlers, all right? Number two, if there are no sellers in this illustration, that means there can only be buyers in the market. So what we'll do is we'll take and find the highest move of that sideways move, go above there and find a place to enter an entry order above that resistance in this case, on one condition, that we have room to the target, all right? So our job before a fundy is to find room for the reaction and then find room to the target, and the minimum ratio must be 1-to-1 risk to reward ratio.